Okay, we need to talk about what in the fuck made me watch The Watcher. Obviously, there may be some spoilers in this video, so if you plan on watching it, please don't watch this. But if you want to spend 5.5 hours doing something other than being bitterly disappointed, then please just don't watch the show. If you've watched it already, God help you. So let's first address my expectations. I expected a show that took me on a journey much like Hot Fuzz, in which the neighborhood is something drastically more sinister than it first appears, mystery would be abundant. The thrill of possibilities would abound as they took us on a magical journey. What we got was the cinematic equivalent of the horrible taste you get when you drink orange juice after brushing your teeth. It's like if you spent 334 minutes of your life watching repeat footage of you snagging your ballsack in your zipper. Now, it's also important for me to point out that I went into this after reading this article. So, I went in expecting it to be bad. But fucking hell, I was not expecting it to be this bad. The show is inspired by true events. Now, without jumping ahead too much, this was both the beginning and the end for the show's critical acclaim. But why is that? Well, here's the thing with real life. Most of the time, it's boring, predictable, and doesn't end in the most satisfying nor exciting way. It's why, even though movies like Paranormal Activity say that they're based on true events, they actually contain paranormal activity. This foregoes the obvious fact that ghosts, of course, don't exist, and you should grow up and read a book, you absolute virgin.
Boom, roasted.
As I said before, the show is based on true events, in which a family move into 657 Boulevard and start to receive letters from some sort of stalker. Now here's the thing, nothing really actually happened in the real life case. The family received a couple of letters, got weirded out, then left. Job done. They didn't even officially move in. They just started renovations, then sold at a loss once they started getting the weird letters. The show's biggest problem seems to be that the writers were torn between having the script mirror real life and allowing for creative liberty. What they ended up with is changing all of the minor details, like the character's likeness to the real people, and keeping all of the soul-crushingly boring stuff, like the fact that the stalker was never found. The show basically just throws wild speculation at the wall for the first couple of episodes, and honestly, I'm there for it. You get mystery, intensity, some kid's ferret gets offed by a creepy home invader. It's a bit Riverdale, but in a cheesy whodunit kind of way. But because the writers were so unwilling to use creative liberty where it actually mattered, they just sort of ditched every possible lead with no good reason. The home invader? He just never appears again. The previous owner that was supposedly hounded by blood-drinking, child-murdering cultists? Never mentioned again. What about the creepy neighbors with a vendetta against the Brunnocks? They get killed, then not killed, then just kind of lose interest and don't really do anything. What about their murderous son that killed two innocent out-of-towners in their home? Well, he was never introduced. The whole thing happened off-screen, and we get told about it by some random character we've never seen and will never see again. When you're at hour 4 and feel like you've been lobotomized by an idiot with a spoon and a can-do attitude, you get almost 2 hours of every possible ending being explored almost entirely through conversations, flashbacks, and exposition rather than anything exciting actually happening. Nobody actually does anything. They're just ridiculously vague to one another, even within their own marriages, and really only seem mildly displeased at what's going on. you have to understand that part of the mind-numbing dryness comes from the fact that the show starts off actually rather well. We go from, there's a cult of blood-drinking child murderers, to, dad is doing it and may not be the person his family thinks he is. Only to finish with the scriptwriters essentially just saying, look, we are so fucking confused about what's happening, we're just gonna pass the confusion on and hope that we trip over the fine line from insanity to genius. To illustrate my point, consider the following. The original family is a family of five, not four, and the three kids knew nothing about the Watcher. Of all the peripheral characters in the entire show, exactly none of them are at all related to any person involved in the actual case in any meaningful way. The private investigator they hired? Not real. I mean, they hired a PI at one point, but this was nowhere even close to what is represented in the show. What about the satanic cult angle? Totally made up. A load of old horseshit, if you will. The tunnels under the house? Yeah, nah, that's not real. What about the murder of the two people at Mitch and Moe's house? Not fucking real, you dumb idiot. Read a fucking book. They allude to the previous owner being harassed by the Watcher. That is a flagrant use of what I would call total bollocks. And one other detail, a final point that I cannot find it within myself to forgive, is that the ferret wasn't real. The ferret was the best fucking character! So, with all that being said, you're telling me the writers could add all of this to the show as creative licensing, but the one thing they felt compelled to keep was that nobody ever really knew who the Watcher was. Not even a cliffhanger, just total disappointment spread over an hour of the final episode. Now, I have some questions of my own on behalf of every normal person that watched the show. Question 1. Why did they spend $7,000 on a security system that includes 10 cameras and you didn't point one at the fucking mailbox? I know, it was sent through the post, but how about having the camera at an angle where you can capture more than just a zoom of your own front door? You have a security system after all. The thing with the Watcher is that they are watching you. So maybe set the cameras to look at where someone might be watching you from. Question 2. Are we seriously just going to write off the fact that Mitch and Moe just came back from the dead and absolutely nobody gave a shit? It's lucky that the writers crammed in the fact that their child was addicted to drugs, because you'd have to be a fucking crackhead to think any of this makes any sense at all. Question 3. Why, when pursuing a man you suspect of attempting to murder your entire family, would you just stop chasing them and opt for the tactic of shouting, "Who are you?" I mean, they might have Jedi mind control powers, to be fair. Fuck knows at this point. This makes no fucking sense. Question 4. You discover tunnels in your home that connect to a network of other homes that fully explains why the stalker is able to get in and out of your home without issue, and you just kind of forget about it. After its discovery, nobody at all even considers it. Not even the crazy bitch who's obsessed with your dumbwaiter because of its historical value. Nobody at all even gives a single iota of a shit. Question 5. After the PI's absolutely moronic confession about being the Watcher is shown to be absolute and complete bollocks, can anyone explain what the fuck the girl in the pigtails is all about? They had 10 cameras on the exterior, and an alarm system with motion sensors at every doorway. And this fucking cow just wanders in. Although the biggest question at this point is who doesn't wake up when someone sits on your bed and starts stroking you? It's like the tactile equivalent of hearing your cat puking. Fuck my life. I can't do this. I can't waste any more time dealing with this fucking show. Don't watch it. It's fucking awful, and I hate it. Also, the daughter is a total moron and definitely a psychopath and should have died instead of the ferret. There, I said it. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do like and subscribe. It really helps me out. Love you. Bye-bye.